So, when you have a good amount of money in your hand, what do you generally do? We generally put the excess amount in the bank and have only the necessary or the things that is going to money that is going to be immediately needed in our hands. In the similar way, the glucose that the body that is present in the body is generally stored in the form of glycogen in the muscles and liver, so that it can be, and only if a little amount is present as free glucose, so that it can be used in the future. So what is in this video, we will see how this stored form of glucose called as glycogen is broken down to produce the glucose, which is the useful form. So glycogen is the storage form of carbohydrate. Where is it present? It is generally present in glucose is generally stored as glycogen in liver and muscle. The density is usually higher in liver, but since the muscle has a higher mass, the total mass, the total amount of glycogen stored is generally greater in the muscle than the liver. So what is the function? The function is to provide glucose when starving, or when the level of glucose in the body goes down, this glycogen is broken down to produce this glucose to meet the energy requirements. So with this, here now we will get into the steps of glycogenolysis. Glycogenolysis, as the name itself indicates, glycogen is lysed. Lysed is generally means breaking down. Glycogen is broken down. So the first step, I have got a beautiful structure of glycogen. Glycogen is a polymer of glucose, but it is not just a straight chain polymer. It is not just linked by straight chain, but it also has some branching. So this is a glucose molecule, and this one is a glucose molecule. And these two are linked by alpha 1,4 linkage. So this is between the first carbon in the first position and the fourth position of the glucose. And the other thing is the branching. There is also, apart from the straight chain or the linear chain, there is also branching, and this is between the first and the sixth carbon. So the first carbon here of this glucose and the sixth carbon of this glucose. So there is two type of linkages. The one is the alpha 1,4 and the next one is alpha 1,6. So here in this picture, I have shown a simple glycogen molecule where each of these small dots are glucose. But the thing is, this red color is called as the branching glucose, branching point. And this three, I have specifically colored it in a different color because I will explain it in a few moments. So the first step is we have glycogen in our hand. The first step is catalyzed by glycogen phosphorylase. So from the name itself, you could have derived that glycogen is phosphorylated. The glycogen is broken down along with phosphorylation. Phosphorylation is generally means addition of a phosphate molecule. Here usually ATP is used, and this step is should need pyridoxal phosphate as the prosthetic group. Pyridoxal phosphate is a coenzyme. You need that pyridoxal phosphatase as the prosthetic group. It can attack only this alpha 1,4 linkage. So only the straight chain between the glucose molecules are broken. So, and also it is that only a few molecules are broken. It is not all these blue color glucose molecules are broken. So it will actually leave those three to four glucose molecule from this branching point. From this branching point, if you consider, 3 to 4 glucose molecules will be left, except that say 5 from here. And also from this branching point, 3 to 4 will be left. So all these points. So in this example, we will say that around 10 glucose molecules it releases. And this glucose is not released as glucose, but actually glucose 1-phosphate. Because you are phosphorylating, right? The phosphate is added in the first position. First position of the glucose, phosphate is added. So these will be released as glucose 1-phosphate. I have represented it as a small red dot over them. So glucose 1-phosphate is released, and you can now see that there is a little number of glucose in this alpha 1,4 linkage, and also this branching. And from the branching point, we have some alpha 1,4 linkage. And now this is the glycogen molecule, simplified glycogen, and also we have released some glucose 1-phosphate. And now what happens? Because now this pink color glucose, you can see it, right? The glucose that are bonded to this branching point, they are actually transferred from this position to this position. This is called as alpha 1,4 to alpha 1,4, because Here also it is bonded in 1,4 fashion. It will move from, this bond will be broken and a new bond will be formed between. So this will be called as alpha 1,4 to alpha 1,4 glucon transferase. A glucon is transferred from the branching point to the straight chain. So this pink color will be transferred to this side. There will be no change in the original glucose that is present here. So now there is only one branching glucose that is present here. So the glycogen is again now simplified even more, giving a long chain of glucose molecules linked via 1,4 linkage and one single branched point. And now we will again see what happens here. This branching point glucose is first removed. How is this removed? This is removed by alpha 1,6 glucosidase. Alpha 1,6 glucosidase. Glucose is removosidase. Removal of glucose from this 1,4 from the glucose that is bonded in the 1,6 fashion. So this glucose is actually released. But the thing is, all the glucose that we released here were glucose 1-phosphate. But the glucose that is released here is actually free glucose. It is not phosphorylated. It is actually released as the free glucose. And now you have got this simple straight chain of 1,4 linked glucose molecules with some free glucose and some phosphorylated glucose. Yes. Here there is the phosphorylated glucose 1-phosphate. Here directly free glucose is released. What happens next? And now we have got the simple thing. You should have guessed that the thing we didn't hear, right? Because the 1,4 glucoses were removed, right? What was the enzyme there? Glucose glycogen phosphorylates. Yes. So it is the same enzyme that comes here too. Glycogen phosphorylase. Easy, right? Glycogen phosphorylase again acts on the 1,4 linkages to produce glucose 1-phosphate. Again, ATP will be used to add phosphate to first portion of the glucose. So now you have got a large number of glucose 1-phosphate and a little number of free glucose too. It is actually said that the ratio is around 8:1. For every 1 glucose, there is actually 8 glucose 1-phosphate. And now you have glucose 1-phosphate in hand. So glucose 1-phosphate has to be transformed to glucose 6-phosphate. Because you have, as you can remember, glucose 6-phosphate will be a structure that is present in the glycolysis pathway. So if it is better to have the phosphate in the 6th position, so that it will be useful for the glycolysis pathway. So that is why we have another enzyme called as phosphoglucomutase. Mutase, as the name indicates, there is a small isomerization mutation. This is how we could remember it, because a small change is happening here. The phosphate in the glucose is actually changing from its first position. From first position, it is changing to the sixth position. Now it is in the sixth phosphate group, sixth position. And there is a two different two different enzymes that are present. Glucose 6-phosphatase is required, because this phosphate in the sixth position can be removed. So that is the enzyme glucose 6-phosphatase, right? In the gluconeogenesis, we have this glucose 6-phosphate. Glucose 6-phosphate will usually convert glucose 6-phosphate to glucose. So this glucose 6-phosphate is only present in the liver. So in the liver, glucose 6-phosphate will be converted to free glucose. But on the other hand, in the muscle, there is no G6Pase. There is no glucose 6-phosphate. So in the muscle end product is usually glucose 6-phosphate. But on the in the liver, we get glucose. So if we are about to use this the product that we have here for glycolysis, glucose, when it is actually getting converted to a pyruvate, will get only 2-phosphate. But when glucose 6-phosphate is converted to glucose pyruvate, you will actually get 3 ATP, because the total amount of ATP that could be get from glycolysis 2 ATP. But since the first ATP is getting saved, because we don't have to expend this first ATP by converting glucose to glucose 6-phosphate, we are actually getting 3 ATPs. So liver there is only production of 2 ATP after glycolysis. But muscle, since there is always already the first step being over, you would actually get 3 ATP. Because if you remember, glucose when converted to glucose 6-phosphate, it has to use the molecule of ATP, right? So this ATP is being conserved. So this is how the glycogenolysis is done to produce glucose, and this glucose could enter glycolysis pathway, glycolysis to produce energy. So in the next video we will see how this glycogen is produced. Thank you, bye.
Like the video, do give a thumbs up and consider subscribing to catch us up in our next videos. Also don't forget to share it with your friends. Bye.